All right, let's first talk about the first fight on the card. I'm not even gonna pronounce the name. I don't even know what is this? This ain't boxing, but are they the same weight class? Because I swear, pause it 1 second. I swear she's like twice the size of her. Wait a minute, is that David Haye? What the heck is he doing here? Oh, I bet David Haye will be decent at this. Anyways, the taller girl, the little Belsi, whatever her name is. She's actually doing all right. I like the trunk. She's probably bigging up Prince Nassim. Probably seen a few of his videos before the fight. But there's not really much going on here apart from, you know, the few slaps and stuff like that. So, I mean, it's good entertainment, but in terms of boxing ability, I think these two need to go back to the gym and actually, you know, practice boxing rather than slapping. The second fight now is a southpaw versus an orthodox fight. I mean, they're doing all right, you know, giving each other a high five with their lead hands, but I mean, no jab, no like combinations. But you know what? That's a decent backhand by the guy in pink. Well, he's not really throwing a hook now, is he? It's more like a slap. I mean, he's doing a Logan Paul thing there. Slap, 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 slap. Decent. Oh, the red guy came back. The red guy is on it. He's not pissing about. Chin up in the air. He's gonna get clipped. No, it's a decent fight. I don't really think they're like great boxers. I think they've just been boxing for like 3 weeks and then they just got told, yeah, do you want to fight on this card? It's good entertainment though. I mean, they're much better than the ladies. The guy in the red here had enough. Uppercut, backhand. He was pissed off. He ran towards him, landed another uppercut, backhand. Boom, he dropped him. Decent fight that, good entertainment. All right, let's talk about this fight now between Tennessee Thresh and Paige Keiki. Is that her name? Thresh. Anyways, Paige, she had the front foot, she was on it. But the thing about Tennessee, she was actually throwing punches. She's on it, she's lifting her lead hand up, protecting her face from that jab. She's actually doing well because she's not just standing there and getting hit. She was actually landing more punches as well. So I don't know how Paige won this, but it was a close fight. I mean, 30-27 was appalling. That judge needs to be investigated. It was a good fight. Both women did well. They did their families proud and their trainers did a good job because they looked much better than the females that were boxing early on. Just quickly, going to the gym every day doesn't really improve you as a boxer. You need to do that extra training that your opponent is not doing. This is why I have started a new way of training called boxing analyzing. What I will be doing is I will be taking clips of you, analyzing it, showing your strengths and your weaknesses so you can improve twice as quick as your opponents. This new training method is being used by so many boxers that I have worked with. Let me work with you and let me help you become a world champion. Here is my email, which is boxingworld@hotmail.com. Just give me an email and let's get to work. And how about this? The first clip that I do for you is going to be completely free of charge so I can show you my work. So what are you waiting for? Send that email and let's get to work. Okay, back to the video. Let's talk about the Taylor and Poppy fight. You know what it was about Sol Poppy? I think he was too hesitant in actually attacking, clinching a lot. Taylor is actually a boxer, so he was using tactics such as clinching, hugging, and landing dirty punches on the inside. And this was actually confusing Sol Poppy and landing the backhand as well. I mean, Poppy can smile all he wants, but that backhand did land and it was frustrating Sol Poppy. I think this was an eye-opener for Sol Poppy and he has actually learned a lot from this fight and I do believe he'll come back stronger. Taylor did very well. I think Taylor would be a good fight for KSI. He's got a good backhand, but Taylor wants to fight Floyd Mayweather. Mayweather would murder this guy. Obviously, everyone wants to fight the money man. But yeah, this fight was decent, but quite disappointing as well because I really wanted Sol Poppy to win. All right, let's talk about the Swarms and Deji fight. You know, Swarms has improved so much since his fight with KSI. This fight was actually good, but I think Deji was just more skillful. He wasn't just landing punches, but his step back as well was preventing himself from being countered by Swarms' hooks and uppercuts. Swarms did land some good combinations and did make the fight interesting, but I think Deji was just a level above him. Okay, main event, KSI versus this guy who's supposed to be an undefeated professional fighter, but KSI did well. You know, he's got like a karate style sort of boxing style, you know, bouncing up and down with his hands down. He needs to be careful doing that against a proper boxer. I don't really think he has a jab, uses his backhand a lot. The fight was quite boring the first round, but let's be honest, going to the second round, yeah, KSI did not knock this guy out with a right hand. He did land a right hand at first, which slightly wobbled his opponent, but I'm telling you now, he landed a clean elbow and that clean elbow knocked his opponent out cold. This fight should have been a disqualification, and KSI's got the audacity to call out Tommy Fury. Tommy Fury beat Jake Paul. Jake Paul would destroy KSI, and all you fanboys out there can say, oh no, he wouldn't, no he wouldn't. Tommy Fury's a boxer and you need to understand that this guy who KSI just fought now ain't no boxer. I've seen his previous fights. He does not fight like a professional fighter. Anyone can be a professional fighter. It's about just getting that license. essence, to be a great fighter, that's a different story. To be a good fighter, that's a different level and a different story as well. So I don't think this fight really proved to the world that KSI is a big threat, because the knockout wasn't a legit knockout, and I believe that this fight should be a no contest or even a rematch.